program today, they look like this. We'd love to have your name and your email, and that'll allow you to allow us to add you to our communications list for this special music series and to give you updates on what's going on. We also always want to make sure that we welcome you if you are so inclined to join us for Sunday worship. We have two services throughout the year from September until May, one at 9 o'clock in the morning and one at 11 o'clock in the morning. The 11 o'clock service here in this room is where you get to hear the wonderful Knox Choir that you will hear during the second part of today's program. And we are always happy to have newcomers if you would like to sing with that group. Membership here at Knox is not a requirement. Just give us a call and let us know that you are interested. We would love to meet you. Now here's the fun part of what I get to talk to you about today, fundraising, which actually does have a really fun part today. As always, we love for you to contribute to the Knox Music Series. This is, of course, free admission to anybody who comes, but we are happy to have your donations, and you can send those to us, but you can also put them in the offering plates that you will find at the entrances to the sanctuary, either at intermission or following the program. The really fun part is that today I get to tell you something awesome about Dr. Earl Rivers, our director of music. He has been here at Knox Presbyterian Church as our music director for 50 years. And 10 years later, we didn't want to do the same thing all over again, and he didn't want that either, so we came up with a wonderful idea. We have started an Earl Rivers Commissioning Music Fund. You will find information about it in your program today. One of Earl's great passions is to celebrate the gift of new music composition by sponsoring wonderful composers from not only throughout the country, but around the world to compose original music for the Knox Choir to sing on Sundays. And we've done how many commissions at this point? We have done 16 commissions at this point to celebrate all kinds of different milestones in the life of the congregation. And the Knox Choir has the opportunity to sing these original works. It's a great part of the life of this congregation. And I know it's a passion of Earl's. Through a wonderful and generous gift from Christy and Scott Holland, we have started a fund to be able to continue this work, not just one at a time, but in perpetuity. We are seeking to raise $75,000 in order to seed that fund and allow us enough money to continue to regularly commission new works on a regular basis. It'll be a wonderful way to celebrate Earl's legacy. If you would like to give a gift to that fund, there is a web address and a QR code, or you can send by snail mail, and all of that information is in your bulletin today. And just to be crystal clear, we don't want to deter you from the ongoing sustenance that this series needs as well. So gifts in the offering plates today, those go to Knox Music Series. If you would like to give to the Rivers Commissioning Fund, use that QR code in your bulletin. Let us know if you have any questions, just give the church a call. It's a wonderful season in the life of the church, and we're glad that you have joined us today. Earl will give us some more information about the music as the concert begins. Thank you so much for being here. You are welcome.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. 15th, we'll be doing the Berlioz, the Infant Christ, L'Enfance Christ. We've done it twice here. It's the story of the Holy Family after the birth. It's a lovely piece. We hope you'll be back. Today for the Mass in C, Deborah Templeman is indisposed, and Ellen Graham will be singing all of the mezzo-soprano solos. If you'd like to sing with the Knights Choir, there are two opportunities. Every year we do a spring piece, and we'll be doing the Haydn Mass in G major with three rehearsals. They begin a week from Thursday, Wednesday, and you get to sing with the chamber orchestra. Well, if you'd like to join us next fall, you let me know and I'll find a place for you. Thanks again for coming to Knox. The Mass in C was Beethoven's first of two Masses. It's a turning point in music history. He followed Mozart and Haydn, who we consider classical composers. And Beethoven sort of ushered in the Romantic period. You'll hear a rather dramatic work in places. He struggled with it because he wanted every word of the text to be understood by his listeners. In fact, he demanded of his publisher it be published and sung in German. The publisher said, no, I can't sell that. But it's rather intimate, and you can follow along with the text on the screen. We hope you enjoy this 45-minute Mass in C by Beethoven.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.